Hello, welcome along. Thank you for joining me again on this watercolour channel. A very simple landscape, as you can see. Nice sky there, some trees there in the background, a body of water with some reflection as well. So it's pretty easy. Follow along with me, and I hope you get something out of this watercolour painting. Please subscribe and click that bell icon if you want to see plenty more watercolour paintings. We're trying to grow this channel, and if we get a certain amount, we'll start a Patreon and do some more exclusive things for you. So starting, as always, with our paper, which we're going to be wetting some areas of the sky. Not all of the sky, we're just going to wet the sky in some places. And we'll be putting some cobalt blue on with a hint, just a very tiny, tiny amount of Paynes grey. And I want the sky to be sort of a broken sky this time. All these paints I'm using are by Art Spectrum. So here we go with the cobalt blue, first of all. And remember, there's just a tiny bit of Paynes grey in amongst that. Just a tiny, tiny amount. So you can see what I mean by a bit of a broken sky there. And when I was laying the water down, it wasn't completely wet all over the sky area. I left some dry spaces as well. That's the body of water now. I'm using the same colours virtually, but I've just watered them right down even further. So it's always good to, if you've got a lake or a river, to put those, to put that river or lake in first, then you can do the land around that. I find that a lot easier. So this mountain here is a mix. This is a mixture of purple and burnt umber, and then we'll be blending into some Prussian blue, and then we'll put a little bit of yellow ochre in as well, all in this mountain area, just to give it some different tones and colours. Some of this mountain will be covered up by some trees, just some of the area of the mountain will be. Prussian blue there now. go with a bit of burnt umber there as well. Some yellow ochre. See those colours just all diffusing into one another. I'm pretty happy with that. There we go, the sky, the mountain, and the water. So we'll do the foreground now. This is some yellow ochre. And we'll be going over this yellow ochre with some olive green as well, and some dark leaf green in places where you'll see the bushes going. Some olive green in there as well. And we'll also have some trees scattered around, and those trees will be reflecting into the water. We'll have to go over that area as well. Some burnt umber. And some dark leaf green. Also some olive green will be going in there too. So that's the green there. We've got some burnt umber going in places as well. We're just getting rid of those hard edges. And more yellow ochre there, just doing the land on the other side there of the water. We'll put a little fence going down that area there. Bits of dark leaf green in areas, just to give the impression of some little bushes. I'm just putting a tree in here. I penciled this tree in. I penciled it in before we put any paint on the paper. And I'm just putting some water, clean water, where I want to put the foliage of the tree. The reason I'm putting water down first is because I just want it to be a nice even flow for the foliage on this tree. I'm going to put some olive green down on this tree here for this tree. Here comes the olive green. It's a really lovely colour by Art Spectrum. And you can just see how nicely it's going on there. Just the area where I put the wet, where I put the clean water. And we'll also have another tree coming out from behind that tree to the left-hand side. We'll do that eventually. Again, I'll put some clean water here. Just put a shrub in here or something, or a smaller tree. Still using olive green. This is using more of yellow ochre now for this random tree here that I'm just doing now. Some dark leaf green for that bush. Some more little impressions there of some shrubs. Put some foliage on the left hand side as well. That tree that you can see is painted in there. Just fixing up down here again. Just making it a bit darker. Softening the edges. some dark leaf green going in now over the olive green. So this is this tree coming out from behind the other tree, the tree here that you can see, just a tree coming out on the left hand side. I'll put a little bit of foliage on some of those branches there as well. You can just leave the branches sticking out from that tree just like I'm doing now, just leave it like that if you want, but I'm going to put some foliage on there. So just keep an eye on that and you'll see the foliage appear on there. And that'll be with a dark leaf green, that foliage that I'll be putting on those branches. There you go. So you'll see that foliage appear very soon. Just doing the edge of the water there. Here we go. Just putting a little tree now on the right hand side, half a tree anyway, coming out from the right hand side. just some shadow coming down where the fence is. Have a bit of a rickety old fence coming down there. All right, let's do the reflection. We want a bit of a reflection from that tree coming out from behind, which we're doing now, a bit slightly darker paint. Painting that fence now. Fence is just black, a matte black. All right, so we're nearly finished. little bit of darker. Could be, I don't know, it could be some moss in the water or something like that. Just fixing up the edge here, down below, just to give the illusion of some grass, some vegetation there from the corner there. So just some shrubs here, that's all we're doing. Just a few shrubs here in the background, using dark leaf green. Okay, we'll take the masking tape off now. I think that'll do. We'll take the masking tape off. just a couple of little bits of grass. Well, I was going to take the masking tape away earlier, but I kept finding things I wanted to do. So I think we're just about right to take away the masking tape in just a second now. I'm just scraping up with the corner of the back of a paint tube just to get some random impressions of grass, some grass anyway. Don't overdo that. Few little shrubs there. There we are, it looked like it needed something there. Okay, here we go. Away from the paper, so your tape doesn't rip into your painting. Always pull away. There it is. Thank you very much for watching. Here is the final reveal. There it is up closer anyway. Hope you enjoyed that. Hope you got something out of it. Very simple watercolor painting. Just of some bush scene there with a body of water. Please subscribe and click the bell icon, and I'll be back again with another watercolour very, very soon. Thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate it. I appreciate and value the subscribers I already have, and I get excited with new subscribers as well. So have a great day. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.